So, last but not least, let us look in chapter 7 on how ASP is used. So, in principle, there are two alternatives. You can use it as a high-level language, so where you express the problem instance as a set of facts, and you encode the problem class as a set of rules. And the idea is that the encoding of the problem class works for all problem instances of the class, right? So you have a separation. This is also called a uniform encoding. And when you then put both the encoding and the set of facts into the ASP system, you can then read off the solutions from the stable models of the facts and the rules. Okay, that's more or less where you model things on a high level. There's also the low-level language aspect, and this is more or less closer how people do it in satisfiability testing, where the idea is you compile your problem into a set of facts and a set of rules, and then you solve the original problem by solving its computation. This is a bad idea. Why? Because the idea of how to encode the problem lies in the compiler and not in the set of rules anymore that actually describe how that describe the problem in the first bullet where you use it as a high-level language. And there's this criterion of elaboration tolerance, which we will look at later on, where the idea is always, what is a good knowledge representation language? It is when there's a small change in the real world, this is reflected by a small change of the representation of the problem in the system, in the language. And if you bury the representation of the problem in a compiler, you're back to programming, right? So this is not a bad idea, and so we would highly recommend the first and not at all the latter. You may actually adapt the latter in the following way. So what you do is you compile the problem not in a set of facts and rules. You compile it just in a set of facts. And then you encode still the problem class as a set of rules. And just to get the idea, where I think a good example is planning. So people are tempted to think, oh, there's a planning operator like moving. Right, you have a precondition, you have an effect, you have perhaps other conditions on it. Anyway, to encode the action into a rule. But again, then you compile it. Well, the idea here would be the action is compiled into a set of facts, perhaps several ones. And then in the encoding, you just say how actions are applied. Okay, so this is a big difference, but we will see this in what follows. And what is also there, this is actually why it's called two sides of a coin. There's actually another half one. Meanwhile, there are APIs, application programming interfaces, where you can actually control the logic program and change it on the fly. Right? The idea is now that you create a solver as an object, and then you send rules over, but you can also withdraw rules or at least make rules inapplicable. And you can also in this way include sensor information and the solver keeps running and you interact with the solver and the environment. This is then the next halfway. So that's it with the last real chapter of this round trip on ASP and the course. Let's wrap up this section, or actually not the section, the whole motivation complex in the summary. See you.